Okay, that does kind of hurt.
9 weeks ago, the biggest season of The Biggest Loser started off with a bang.
What is going on in here? What is going on in here?
Come here!
22 of the fattest contestants ever began a journey to get their lives back.
Pounds.
But it's been harder than they ever imagined.
It was so much more difficult than I would have imagined, and I was imagining the worst.
In the very first week, 9 contestants went home.
It's time for you to say goodbye, but remember, it may not be for long.
As their partners battled it out on the ranch for their return. So far, 11 players have been eliminated from the competition. But their journey was far from over. They've gone on to continue their Biggest Loser lifestyle at home. Now, 11 players remain. Each week, they've pushed themselves to their limits.
You have been at this for 24 hours, and this is the end.
Some have triumphed. Some have crumbled under the pressure.
Step up.
Get some air.
I can't stop.
Try and pick up that dumbbell and push it over your head.
It's been an emotional roller coaster for the contestants and their trainers.
I'm sick of just words. Talk. Shut the up. Just stop talking and do it.
Dan, no. Come on, treadmill now. I'm not going to say it again.
This is exactly what you have been working for.
So far, the contestants on the ranch have lost over half a ton of weight. And shattered records.
That is the most anyone has ever lost in a single week on campus. Dane, you have lost 100 pounds in 8 weeks.
But there's so much more to come. With 9 weeks left, the competition is only getting more intense.
You're gonna take Felipe down tomorrow.
Yes, I am.
The last workout, he didn't want to work with me.
You worked everybody. And I stood on that treadmill 2 hours and a half wondering, when I was gonna get my turn? And you did it. You did it.
Who will have the strength, the stamina, and the willpower to win the biggest competition on television?
This is it. You are halfway there.
Last chance workout. Let's go.
Shut up. Focus and do the work.
You are athletes. I'm going to be working you out like athletes.
Yes. Excellent. One more.
Tonight, see who will survive this week and continue their fight to become the next Biggest Loser.
This was their first elimination with us as the blue team and voting one of our own off. Tonight, my decision was to vote for Dane.
I voted for Dane.
Dane.
Dane went home tonight, and that was the best thing that could have happened because he's a huge threat.
Now that Dane's gone, I don't know what's gonna happen. The one person here who I, leaned on and who
really believed in me and always gave me the encouragement to do more is gone.
Well, if anything, honestly, it's really stupid on your part, really stupid.
I had no idea that it was gonna be Dane that went home.
I have to vote for Ron.
For me, it's scary because I haven't had time to bond with Kathy and Kristen and Ron. And, you know, they're not gonna send each other home, they're gonna send me home.
Honestly speaking, me, Kristen, and Ron are original Bob's team, and we are going to stick together.
I know it's gonna be hard for you, but I know you can do it. You're a competitor. You're awesome at everything you do.
What if I can't? Then I'm
today we wound up in a cooking school called Chef's Inc. All of us have no idea what's gonna happen.
Welcome! How are you?
Hey!
Come on in! What's going on? Nice to see you all. What's going on? How's it going? Nice to see you.
Rocco DiSpirito is standing right there. He's like a world-class chef. It was so cool to see him.
Well, I'm a huge fan of good food, but not all food is good for you, as you know. And today, I want to talk to you about some of the worst food you can eat. Guess what it is?
Fast food.
Fast food. The problem is Americans can't get enough of it. Last year, Americans spent $110 billion on fast food. It's a lot of money.
Billions. And I contributed. That was part of me. I was a drive-thru fanatic.
Any addictions to fast food in this group? Okay. Before. Lots of unhappy meals?
Yeah. Unhappy meals.
Unhappy.
I worked at a fast food place.
Oh, perfect.
So it's I'd eat there 3 times a day.
Any fried chicken lovers out there?
Right here.
Yeah.
Right here. I'd eat 3 times a week, and I'd probably eat a bucket by myself.
3 times a week?
About 3 times a week.
Wow. Fan of pizza?
Fan of pizza.
A typical stuffed crust meat pizza has 490 calories, 27 grams of fat, and 1,570 milligrams of sodium per slice.
1,500.
So in one slice, this is how much fat you'd have eaten. But anyway, would you let me eat this?
No.
Think about that. How many slices of pizza would you say you ate a day?
If I sat down, I could probably eat the whole pie.
So if you ate the whole pie, Ron, it's 4,000 calories.
To me, it wasn't shocking. I mean, look at me. You just, you know, it tastes good, so you ate it.
We all know what this is, right? This is a stuffed burrito. A typical stuffed burrito has over 1,100 calories with 47 grams of fat. And over 2,600 milligrams of sodium.
In any given day, I would probably eat at least 2 burritos a day. Just those 2 burritos that I would have before lunch, I was already way over my calorie intake for the whole day.
A typical triple cheeseburger has 1,230 calories, 82 grams of fat, and over 1,500 milligrams of sodium. And if you add fries, the fat in a typical cheeseburger with fries is 110 grams.
Oh my God.
I would stop for lunch and I'd probably have 3 double cheeseburgers and a large fries. And then on the way back, my wife's gonna kill me when she hears this, is I would grab the same exact thing before I'd go home for dinner.
So I've invited you here today for a little challenge. So follow me, come on.
All right.
I'm definitely sweating bullets right now because, you know, we have a world-class chef here. World-class chef, I'm not.
Wow. Lots of good-looking food here. All right, here's what we're gonna do today. Both teams are gonna make a healthy version of each of the fast foods I showed you today. A healthy burger, a healthy taco, burrito, Mexican entree, a healthy pizza. You'll be judged on the taste and the calorie content. So the best tasting version with the lowest calories, lowest amount of fat, will be the winner. Let me emphasize, it has to taste good. It can't just be low calorie. It has to taste really good.
I suck at cooking. I know, common misconception, mother of five can cook really well. No.
You can use any of the ingredients you see here, but you only have 30 minutes. The winner will win dinner cooked by me. In addition, someone on the winning team will be chosen at random to receive an extra vote in this week's elimination.
We have to win this challenge. We need that extra vote. And for me in particular, I feel like I might be going home this week if I fall below. So I'm gonna do everything I can to try and win this challenge.
Big stakes, guys. All right, so you've got 30 minutes, and the 30 minutes starts now. Hey everybody, this is Rocco DiSpirito, and one of the best ways to improve just about any dish is to add dried or wild mushrooms. They go great in sauces, vegetables, or raw in salads, and they're the perfect way to add tons of flavor without packing on any unwanted calories. All right, are you guys ready?
Yep.
You need to make the healthy version of all the fast food entrees that I showed you. A healthy burger, a healthy taco, burrito, Mexican entree, a healthy pizza. You'll be judged on the taste and the calorie content. The winner will win dinner cooked by me. The loser will have to wash dishes, and I make a big mess. So don't lose this for that reason alone. In addition, someone on the winning team will be chosen at random to receive an extra vote in this week's elimination. So you've got 30 minutes, and the 30 minutes starts now. Good luck.
Having 11 fat people in a small little kitchen doesn't exactly go very well.
Can I use the scale?
The blue team didn't win a single challenge or the weigh-in last week, so I'm like, we've got to nail this.
I'm gonna put some garlic and stuff. Susan, you think? That's perfect.
We're gonna make a stuffed hamburger with peppers, onions, and mushrooms in it, and some mustard and ketchup on the side.
Grab me a full tomato. Laura and I are gonna make the burger. So I grab the bison out, and I grab the onions.
Helen, do you want the lower one or the upper one?
We're like, oh my God, are we gonna be able to do this in 30 minutes?
The burrito seemed pretty easy to me. I know how to make pico de gallo. I know how to make salsa, and I was thinking, okay, just make some turkey and throw it in a burrito with some pico, and it'll be good.
They don't need to be sliced.
Nope.
Really?
Kathy and I are going to be making the pizza, and I'm pretty worried about the half-hour time limit because we don't even have an oven preheated. Pizza only takes 10, 12 minutes to cook if I can get the oven hot enough.
You still playing with that same pizza?
Yeah.
Only 20 minutes left.
I've made pizza a lot at home with my dad because that's what he did for 20-some years. We have to do all vegetables, no meat, and basically hope my dad screws up somewhere.
Excuse me. My job is to make the burrito, and my plan was to mix no-fat yogurt with sweet chili sauce, and it actually makes a really good sour cream.
So, guys, remember, you are fighting for an extra vote at the elimination.
It was hot a minute ago.
Ron, are you having oven problems?
Yeah, the function three, like, keeps coming on.
Do you have an oven not ready, is what you're saying?
Just a second.
Well, hopefully you have a plan B. You got about 10 minutes left, guys. 10 minutes left. It's no joke at this point.
No,
who needs help?
450, 470.
We had a disaster near our cookout with Rocco.
Is this a broiler? How can I get this broiler to work? The time is ticking.
This is half an ounce, okay?
So put it on the burger. Just concentrate on the burger. Just concentrate and get this burger looking good.
Who just turned this oven off?
I tried to mess with it.
We only got 5 minutes left. The dough's not gonna be cooked.
Thank you.
I need you to put that broiler on.
3.5 minutes left, guys. You have to have everything plated. You have 3.5 minutes left. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay. Who made the burger on the black team? Tell me a little bit about your burger.
It's actually bison.
Bison, okay.
Yeah, and it has some chopped onion mixed inside of the burger with spices and portobello mushroom with feta cheese on top. I'm like, oh my God, I can't take it. Just tell me already. What do you think? How does it taste? Because you know what? In the midst of all this cooking, we never tasted our burger. So I have no clue.
Tell me about your burrito.
Use the wheat tortilla, extra lean turkey. You'll love it.
Mike, tell me how you made this.
The marinara sauce is organic marinara sauce with sweet basil, oregano, and garlic powder. It's on top is baby spinach, sliced tomato and onion with a low-fat mozzarella cheese.
Now, what happened with the dough? It looked like you were giving it a good massage for about 15 minutes. So tell me how you made your burger.
We stuffed it with mushroom.
You stuffed the burger?
Mm-hmm.
Someone got fancy over there. Would you like me to put some of this stuff in here?
Sure.
All right. Is all of this counted in your calories?
Yeah. They say if you can't take the heat, get out of the kitchen. I wanted to run out of that kitchen.
Who made the burrito? Tell me all about it.
Lean ground turkey and a little bit of rice and some Southwest Chipotle seasoning with garlic powder and onion powder. The yogurt in place of the sour cream. With,
right here?
Yes. I can't walk.
Ron, I don't think this piece ever got cooked, did it?
We had some oven problems.
Yeah. But, I was going to make sure the oven's on.
It's a whole wheat crust with a sweet basil sauce. It's got caramelized onions, Kalamata olives, and mushrooms, grated Parmesan cheese, and Romano cheese. All I cared about was beating my son to make my pizza taste better than his. And I saw his pizza, and I know mine tasted better.
All right, guys, I have the results of the healthy food cook-off, but we're going to go dish by dish. So let's start with pizza. In the father-son pizza smackdown, the winning pizza tasted better and had lower calories. The calories for one slice of your pizza was 276 calories versus 470 for the original. Blue team. Okay, guys, the original calorie count on our bad burrito was 1,100 calories. Blue team, your burrito had 485 calories. Black team, your burrito had 417 calories, so congratulations on reducing the calories. In terms of flavor and presentation, you scored equally. Equally bad. But because the black team's burrito was lower in calories, you guys win the burrito challenge.
All
right. So it all comes down to the burger. The black team's burger tasted much better than the blue team's burger. So it came down to calories. Black team, your burger had only 303 calories. Blue team, your burger had 525 calories. The ketchup and the mustard was the downfall. The black team's burger won.
The ketchup and mustard's gonna haunt me for the rest of my life.
As the winning team, you get to come up one at a time and pick one of the fortune cookies.
The most important thing here is the extra vote at the elimination. And the fortune cookie will either read one vote or it'll be a blank piece of paper.
Blank. Oh, blank. Oh, blank again. Let's see.
One vote.
One vote!
Having this extra vote makes me feel a lot more confident that I'm probably going to be guaranteed at least another week here.
All right, congratulations, black team. Job well done. I'll see you back at the ranch for what's going to be a fabulous dinner. Blue team, get your dishwasher shirts on.
Coming up, the blue team gets a surprise visitor to help them knock out the competition. And later, the players have a weigh-in that puts both teams in jeopardy.
Tonight's weigh-in is unlike anything we have ever done. You will not be weighing in against each other.
We won the challenge, and the great thing about it is I don't have to cook dinner tonight. I gotta have Rocco cook it for us, so obviously he's gonna cook up something healthy, and I'm excited.
So the fourth most popular fast food meal is fried chicken, of course. We're gonna make sure it's crispy and juicy, but we're gonna unfry it. It's never gonna touch any oil. From here, it goes into whipped egg whites. Panko breadcrumbs that have been toasted. Very important you don't overcook it. Well, I'll take out the sweet potatoes. The number one most nutritious vegetable on the planet.
The smell is great inside the kitchen, so obviously I knew that we were gonna get something really good to eat.
Okay, here are your mashed sweet potatoes.
Ooh.
Coleslaw, super duper crispy unfried chicken, and the gravy to go with it.
Yummy.
You guys help yourselves with that. Fast food can be healthy. We proved that today. So there's no reason to ever eat any of that stuff ever again. Guys, thank you so much. I had a really great time. I hope you enjoyed it as well.
Thank you so much.
Getting our dinner cooked by Rocco was absolutely amazing. I mean, Rocco is a chef and a good-looking one, too.
What stinks in here? Seeing the black team sitting down at this beautiful table, having food that was cooked by a world-famous chef, and then we had to come in and do the dishes, it was like adding insult to injury.
Good job on the pizza.
Can we have some water, guys? Will you bring us some water, blue team?
Can I have some water?
Taking us off campus, and I am so excited because, you know, we've had a rough week. We don't have an extra vote. We need to do nothing but focus on the blue team, and Bob feels that getting us off campus will be the best way to get the most intense workout we possibly can get in.
24 Hour Fitness has this exclusive class that they teamed up with Everlast. It's called the Everlast Shadow Boxing Workout. It is a sweat fest, and it's something new, it's something exciting. I thought it'd be fun for us to do. So what do you think?
Cool.
A little shadow boxing. I know, Aubrey, you were what, a boxer for what, 3 years or something?
Yeah.
I expect you to be the best.
I amateur boxed for 3 years, and I was undefeated. I love boxing. Some people, it's their football. Some people, it's basketball. I love watching boxing.
All right, I have someone very special behind this door that's going to help with the workout. You ready?
We walk in, and I see this guy jump roping in the corner.
What's up, guys? How you doing, buddy?
Sugar Ray Leonard, this is a six-time world champ standing here waiting for us to get in there and shadow box with us.
How you doing, sweetheart? How you doing, babe?
Sugar Ray Leonard. Like, we're going to box with Sugar Ray Leonard. I can't even believe this is happening.
I am such a huge fan of Biggest Loser because you guys are fighters. And the thing about your journey is the fact that it's not all physical, it's mental, it's psychological. So my whole philosophy is about power. It's called POWER, which is an acronym for prepare, overcome, win every round. So what you guys are doing is so inspirational, it's so amazing, but you know what? It's all there. It's what you want, because the mind is so powerful. Because even now, I'm 52 years old, and I still work out as a boxer, I just don't get hit. No more. But I train as a fighter because I think that boxing is one of the most, if not the total body workout. And it's a wonderful, wonderful program.
Okay, so speaking of that, it's time for us to get a workout in, you guys. Okay. Let's get geared up and go.
Let's go. One, two. Oh. Fantastic. One, two. Good. One, two, hook. One, two, hook. There you go. You got it.
Shadow boxing was fun. I think whether you get your heart rate up on a treadmill or doing something like that, that is a lot more fun than running on a treadmill.
You go under and over. You look good. I like it. Two punches when you duck. Here, one, two. Go back. One, two. One, two.
I didn't think it was going to be such a tough workout. Just, you know, a few drills that we did, I was already sweating. I'm just like, holy cow. And it was fun. It was something different.
Double jab. Cross. Perfect. One, two, hook. Uppercut. I want you to keep those abs pulled in like Sugar Ray's going to come over there and punch you in them. One more time.
What a workout, guys.
All right, guys, so that was your Everlast Shadow Boxing workout. I want to thank Sugar Ray Leonard for being a part of this.
Listen, I am now a part of your team. So we can't lose. So the only objective is to win, to lose that weight, to stay disciplined, to stay, I call it tunnel vision. It's total tunnel vision. You know what? Nothing else matters. You gotta always be sharp, prepared, ready to fight, all right? God bless you all, guys, and kick some butt.
Thank you.
Take care.
Thank you.
Because of the fact that we're mixed up into black and blue and there's gameplay starting up, it was so nice to hear those words of strength and believing in yourself, because it makes you realize, again, we are here for ourselves. We got to be strong and not let everything else poison us.
You guys have been fantastic.
So much.
Considering what's at stake for this next weigh-in, I could not ask for a better workout. The black team may have an extra vote, but we just had Sugar Ray Leonard work us out in the gym. I think it's just the boost we needed.
Hey, guys.
Hey, Dr. H.
I'm thinking, why is Dr. H in that gym? What is he doing here? Because anytime you see Dr. H, you think it's going to be good news or it's going to be bad news.
Hey, guys. Well, I just wanted to anoint you guys king and queen of the major big-time weight loss losers. You guys are both record breakers.
Thanks. Yeah.
You lost 134 pounds of hydrated fat, but you gain probably 20 plus or minus pounds of muscle. So you lost 134 pounds of fat that's never, ever been done in
cool.
3 months.
Sweet.
When I first came to the ranch, I was basically, Dr. H said, you could die within 5 years. I flashed from being a lazy couch potato to someone who's lost a ton of weight and is a gym rat, basically, now.
Up! Ugh! Yes!
It's a great, great feeling.
Tara, you have done something that's never been done as well, 29% weight loss.
29%?
In 3 months, unbelievable.
Here I am 9 weeks later, more than 27% of my body fat gone.
Thanks, Dr. Thanks.
Keep it up. Okay, bye-bye.
Bye.
And I'm only halfway through. Holy.
Yeah, have a seat. Do you remember that first day when we were doing your treadmill test?
Mm-hmm.
You did essentially what we'd expect for kind of a fit 68, 69-year-old woman to do. So we just redid that test, and now we're going to compare you to fit 31-year-olds. Where do you think you fell for fit 31-year-olds?
I don't have any idea.
I couldn't even tell because you were off the charts. You did so good.
Yay.
That, you know, you went from horrible condition to superb. You know, we're beyond superb. So I think that you've really kind of sunk in with the exercise.
I love it. I do. It makes me feel good.
Okay.
Thank you.
Get back out of it. You know, we've never had a person on the show that was post-bypass. You have a very different type of fat distribution on you because you had the stomach surgery. So you break every rule. Every rule.
13 years ago, I had a procedure called Roux-en-Y gastric exclusion, which is bariatric bypass surgery. I was a little over 500 pounds, and it seemed like there was no other option at the time. So you try to take the easy way out, but I'm an example is that, you know what, it doesn't always work.
You were one of the few contestants that was losing a little bit of muscle. You know, we really are incredibly firm here about getting all the contestants to gain muscle while they lose weight, because we think that's the healthy way to lose weight. But a diabetic has trouble with that. You know what? I think in the last couple of weeks, things have kind of gone our way. And I have to say, you know, you're now starting to pick back some of that muscle. Your blood sugars are finally coming down a little bit more. We're needing less insulin.
Here, we eat regular food. We exercise a lot. And it's something that you can do at home, you know. And here, with knowing my sons need to do the same thing, I need to set an example for them. I can see that the goals are attainable.
My diabetes is getting more under control than it was. You know, for the most part, it was pretty good news. We're going in the right direction.
Thank you.
Great. Okay. Talk later.
Mm-hmm.
Bye-bye.
Bye now.
So let's try to get a workout in right now. You guys, after the gym, start warming up. You sit on the bike.
Right.
Okay. And Tony, give me 5 minutes before you head up.
I held Sione back because I wanted to reach out to him again, and I know he's been struggling with missing Bob, and he feels like he's a traitor to Bob if he works out with me, and it's just a difficult situation.
Here's what I'm gonna say to you. Maybe we can make the best of a bad situation.
I just think it was a weird week.
Mm-hmm.
You know? Maybe it just took me a little longer, but I'm good. It's just I'm adapting to change.
I know.
You know, so it's I've made up my mind that, you know, I've got to. I mean, changes could be for the better.
Just stay open and just see what there is to learn from it.
Yeah.
Obviously, you know, you have Bob's love and affection, and it's like, you know, you'll have all my attention right now.
Yeah.
You're such an amazing athlete, you know? It's just, I just think it'd be really fun to work you out.
Yeah. No, and I'm excited for you to work me out.
Then let's go work out.
Okay.
Come on.
Let's do it.
All right. See if you can't break an elliptical machine today.
Let's do it. You know, last week was just crazy hectic, but I made up my mind that I was not going to hold back. I was going to give her everything that I gave to Bob. So I'm going to train with her. I'm going to take the best that she has to offer, and she's going to kick my butt.
Two, we're going to do 10. Three, all the way down. Full range of motion. Good. 9, 8. And push up. Pull from here. Good. All the way to the ground. 4, way up higher. 3, 2, hand these back over to me. Okay, the kind of training you're doing is called metabolic training. Extremely explosive, high intensity training in circuits. 3 more, push. Beautiful, abs are engaged. Travel, up, push. Yes, there you go. And I want you to roll with it. That's it. Flow. 10 seconds. 9, 5.
Oh!
You okay, baby?
Oh!
You twist it. Okay. Can we get some ice right away and Sandy up here?
My right ankle lands on one of the legs of the bench, and it inverted my ankle. And the pain that I felt just dropped me to the ground.
This is the one that hurts,
yes.
Right?
Yes.
The first thought that comes to my mind is like, gosh, I hope he's not out of commission the whole week.
Okay, how you doing, baby? Hurting just as bad, but getting any better?
Sione is like a bull on our team. I mean, we need him.
I gotta get an MRI on his leg.
Right now, my ankle, it was a level 1 sprain, which is the best of the sprains to have. So I know that during this challenge, I basically just got to suck it up and push it.
Hi, everyone.
Hi.
Last year, 1 in 8 Americans struggled with hunger. That is over 35 million men, women, and children. Today, we all have the opportunity to do something about it. So let's go inside and check it out. Come on.
All right.
It's really ironic that 1 in 8 people goes hungry, and everyone here has eaten well more than their fair share of food before they came to the ranch. So it's almost like we're giving back for all the extra food we've eaten.
Welcome to the Los Angeles Regional Food Bank, a member of the Feeding America Network. Last year, this facility helped feed over 500,000 people. All thanks in no small part to the hardworking volunteers who did exactly what you all are going to do today. So let's talk about today's challenge. Your job is to take the donated food, assemble it into a kit, and then take those kits across the warehouse. Load them onto the trucks. There are 100 kits you will have to make. You will take this 100 to the truck where you will find 50 more that are ready to be loaded. You will load 150 kits onto your truck. The first team to do it wins. When you're finished, the two teams will have loaded up enough food to feed 1,200 people for a day.
This challenge is very personal to me. When I had my first two kids, I went to food banks and I took advantage of those resources. To be on this side and help give the food instead of take it, it feels amazing.
And in return for winning today's challenge, each member of the winning team will receive free groceries for a year from General Mills.
Wow.
Oh my gosh. Getting a year's supply of groceries, that's huge for Aubrey and I. You know, we both have big families, so that alone is worth fighting for.
The winning team will also be featured in a national campaign advertising Cheerios. The winning team also gets letters from home.
Letters from home is one of the best prizes that you can win here because, you know, I have children at home and, you know, hearing from my wife, it just will give me a boost to get through the next week.
Blue team, you have 5 members playing in this challenge, which means black team, you have to choose someone to sit out. Why don't you guys talk about it, figure out who is not going to compete today.
I can load fast.
Yeah. We discuss it and we're thinking, okay, we need powerful people to run this food. So our team decides that Laura, you know, will sit this one out and cheer us on.
Black team, I need a decision.
Allison, I'll be sitting out.
Okay, then let's get to it. Right this way.
We have to win this challenge. We're gonna win this challenge.
I ain't gonna let blue team beat us, are you kidding me? This is something to win.
There is a lot at stake in this challenge. Are you ready?
Ready, yes.
On your mark, get set, go! Felipe and Kristen are setting up the food. They're getting it on the conveyor belts. Helen, Ron in charge of making the kit. Fiona, Mandy, Mike are running through the warehouse to the trucks to load the kits that are already made. Fiona loads the first 2 kits for the black team. Mandy's right behind him for the blue team.
Hold on, Felipe.
Okay.
Ron getting his kits organized. Tara loads the finished kits and is off to the trucks for loading.
Come on.
Kristen still steadily putting together kits, getting them on the conveyor belt. The first team to load 150 kits wins groceries for a year, and not to mention letters from home. Here comes the blue team fighting for groceries for a year.
Go around front next time.
Black team has committed 2 players for loading the kits onto the trucks while blue team has only 1. Let's see whose strategy pays off.
Can we slow down? Mama, where's the food?
I got it.
Helen's struggling. That food is quickly walking away from her. Blue team decided to keep 3 team members back here at the conveyor belt. I think helping Ron keep those things organized. Tara's back. Aubrey's back. They're loading up more kits onto their cart. Black team, blue team are at a tie. This is going to come down to the wire. Ron may be lagging behind. He's let food pass him by.
Okay, slow it down.
Okay.
You got this, guys.
Black team is back. Remember, the first team to load 150 kits wins this challenge.
Got it? Okay.
Come on back. Helen, realizing what a workout this is.
Then leave that.
Oh, no!
Pick it up. Slowly.
How's it going, Ron?
Good, but that's the last one for a while.
Okay.
Tara and Kathy on their way to the warehouse with another cart. Here comes the black team again. Another 9 kits for the black team.
Watch out, Mike. Don't drop anything.
Blue team is on a roll. They are catching up with the black team. Black team is neck and neck with the blue team now. It all comes down to how fast those kits can be made. Helen's starting to look like an old episode of I Love Lucy.
Hey, Christian, put another one on.
room for the needy. Just do that one back first. Do that one back first.
Okay. Oh. Down, down. Up. Up. Here comes the blue team fighting for groceries for a year. She hustles around the corner, gives Kathy her next group. Come on. Looks like the blue team is getting ahead. Mandy gives blue team a lead. This is a foot race with only a few kids left for each team. Blue team, black team in a run. They're hustling it out, racing to the finish.
Just don't let them fall. Don't let them fall.
Earlier tonight, during the pop challenge, black team won again. And Laura received an extra vote for the elimination.
One vote.
One vote!
And a weigh-in that will surprise everyone.
You all are about to have the chance to win immunity. But if you lost, one person from each team will be going home tonight.
And now for the conclusion of the challenge.
Remember, the first team to load 150 kits wins this challenge. Blue team, black team in a run. They're hustling it out, racing to the finish.
Black team only has four more kits to finish. Ron and Kristen and Felipe and Helen back at the conveyor belt, still packing.
Mandy going back.
Keep going.
Okay. Last one.
Black team loads their last part and they are off to the truck.
The black team looking at their final four.
Woo!
Last one. And this game is over.
Woo!
Bring it in, guys. You guys are awesome.
Oh. That's it. Congratulations, black team. You have won today's challenge.
Yeah. We won! I want a year of groceries and lettuce from home. Are you kidding me? That's the best.
We're winners again. You know, we're just a really strong team.
Here comes the blue team, determined to finish. Is this the last of it?
Still gotta load this truck for the hungry.
Blue team finishes up. One more kit.
It'll take me a minute, but I got it.
Aubrey takes the last kit. All right, blue team finishes the challenge. And something to think about, you guys. You fed 1,200 people for a day with what you did here today. You got an idea of what the volunteers here do every single day.
It feels so rewarding to know that today, during this challenge, we are giving back. And now that I'm more aware of what's going on, I'm gonna donate my time and donate my money and try to help.
No, we can't help everyone everywhere, but we can help someone somewhere. And I think that's the whole message of this challenge, is to make America realize that, you know, you can do something instead of just sitting on the couch and wasting your life away.
Thank you, you guys.
Thank you.
See you soon. Bye. Yeah.
It's frustrating because I wanted to win this for Aubrey so bad, because she doesn't, you know, she's got five kids at home. It breaks my heart to see her crying because I know she tried hard.
It felt good to win this challenge, but knowing that the blue team lost again, there was kind of a bittersweet to it. I feel bad that I won the year's supply of groceries when I don't need it. You know, it's sad that the blue team has to lose when we have to win.
It's not your fault.
Mandy and I were so upset because it's a combination of wanting the prize so bad and being tired of losing and having to watch black team celebrate.
Oh. That didn't work.
Which is frustrating.
I know.
I mean, we have lost, I think, 4 or 5 challenges in a row, and Black Team doesn't let us forget it. They're playing around on carts and, like, coming through the warehouse, like, woohoo!
Part of what we won from the challenge was letters from home. And just going through and opening these letters, it was awesome. And I received letters from Alex, my son, and my husband, Russell.
I am looking forward to having a long and healthy life with you, my love, my best friend, my life, my wife, my Helen.
It's just so good to know that they're okay at home. Reading those letters makes me want to work harder, makes me want to look really good.
Sarah, you are a beautiful person inside and out. You deserve the best.
I got a letter from my mother, and she is near and dear to my heart. She was just telling me that people are looking to me for inspiration. And because I can do it, she knows that they're going to believe that they can do it. That's an amazing feeling.
I'm grateful to be your wife and so glad that you picked me to spend eternity with. I got a letter from my wife and, you know, basically just telling me how much she loved me and that they're supporting me back home. The kids are good. Sokai's walking all over the thinking he's so smart and funny. Found out my son's walking all over the place. When I left, he was crawling. To miss my boy, take his first steps, you know, that's something any parent wouldn't want to miss. But, you know, it drives me a lot more to work harder, to see my family again and spend more time with them in the future.
This was worth winning. I miss my wife. I miss hearing her voice. Not being able to talk to my wife for that long and my kids and to have a letter written by her was awesome. Life over here is hard without you. But I know everything will be fine. I'm still exercising, trying to look good for you. I can't wait to start our new healthy life together with our kids. You be yourself, and remember who you are and who you represent. Ofalayatu, your eternal wife. Love you.
I've always been a million miles away, but things are gonna change. I just wanna come home.
Knowing that she's working hard just inspires me to work even harder here. It didn't make me homesick. If anything, it just gave me more fire. It gave me more fire to really work hard this week.
This morning I was thinking about the challenge, and I noticed yesterday that Aubrey was really upset that they didn't win, and, you know, she has 5 kids. That has to be tough. I don't need a year's supply of groceries, and, you know, I'm a college student, you have 5 kids, and I don't know if you need it, but, you know, will you let me give that to you?
Oh, that's so awesome, Mike. Thank you so much. Yeah. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Wow. That's awesome. I couldn't even stop smiling. Like, I still can't stop smiling. That was the sweetest thing that anybody could have ever done. Like, really, really, honestly, the most selfless thing. I didn't tell anybody else this, but when my first 2 kids were born, I was single. And I used the food from the food banks and the food drives. You're in a position to where these kids that you made the choice to create and no one else did, it's not their fault that they can't eat, you know, when they need to. You really have to swallow your pride when you're having your two kids walk up with empty boxes and receive food from volunteers. And so I think the whole entire challenge was a really emotional thing for me.
Yeah, it was for everybody, but, you know, now that I know this, you especially had to be.
So, yeah, I appreciate it. That's so awesome. Anytime. Thank you so much. The fact that Mike gave me his reward proved that we can still be good people, even though we are wearing different color shirts.
Mike just gave me his year's worth of groceries.
What?
He did.
Oh my God.
Is that so cool or what?
Oh my God. Oh my God.
Just to hear that Mike was like, here, Aubrey, I want you to have my groceries for a year. That's it. That's all I wanted her to have. I can't even thank Mike enough.
Your son,
Ron. Good job, Dad.
You're very welcome. I'm so proud of my son, Michael. My wife and myself try to drill that into both my sons, that, you know, you just need to do the right thing. Just go ahead and do it. And so he did it.
Hey everybody, this is Rocco DiSpirito. If you love breaded foods like chicken parmesan, here's a simple way to make them healthier without sacrificing taste. Instead of preparing them with beaten whole eggs and enriched white flour, use egg whites, whole wheat breadcrumbs, and soy flour. That'll help you cut calories and fat without cutting out some of your favorite foods.
What's going on?
We won again!
Woo! Okay, let's not be too gloaty about this.
No,
because I've always seen it go, it's like, what? And then, you know, we have a weigh-in. So I just get nervous with karma. I want to be very humble about this. I am proud of you. What happened?
We had to bag groceries at the food bank.
Helen was packing all the food, and then basically Mike, Tara, and me were like the runners. We had to load the truck.
Did Laura have to sit out?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Laura sits out of the challenge. I've got Sione, whose ankle's bothering him, Helen, who's almost 50, and yet Laura, who has zero injuries, is sitting out. It really raises a question about her. You know, she's like, she loves to play the weak, helpless victim.
Let's just, you know, have a good last chance workout.
What do you think?
Sounds good.
Come on, Tara.
I'm coming.
Last chance workout. Go!
Push!
Last chance workout, Ron. Three.
Last chance, Sione. Go! Go! Three, two more. Pull.
Last chance workout. Head up, baby. Head up. 12.
Jab. Cross.
Pull. Back. Yes! That's amazing. Push!
2. 8. Last chance workout, Mandy. You gotta hit up higher. Volleyball drills.
Bob has not given up an ounce. He has been on me all week long.
Grab it. Face me. What? What's up?
What if I work this hard and I still go home?
Well, what if you work this hard and you're the biggest loser? Huh? What about that one? What if you work this hard and you guys win the weigh-in? Right?
Yeah. This is so hard.
Let's go.
I'm so concerned about me going home because I don't have a bond with Kathy, Kristen, and Ron. They were on Bob's team in the first place. If they're still playing with their hearts, I would be the first one to go.
You're gonna fight like you're gonna have nothing to lose because you have everything to lose.
Yeah.
I just need you staying positive all day today, okay?
Okay.
You're not going home. You've worked too hard. You're gonna stay here in this house. It's not your time to go.
That seriously went through my mind like 500 times during the workout. Keep going because you have to do this. You have to have a decent number in order to stay here.
What are you thinking about right now?
plan the way in.
That's right.
Keep going, we got it. Keep going, go, go.
No,
let go.
Do not stop.
Keep going, you're right there, Laura.
Come off, come on the floor. Laura cried all week one.
I need to get some air. I can't stop. I feel like it's coming.
It's not coming. Get on the treadmill. It's week 9, and she's still locked up in this dynamic of being a victim. And that's gonna take some time to break. We have a problem. You know what that problem is? I'm not yelling at you. When's the last time you can remember me yelling at you? You know how bad that is? Why are you always last?
I don't know. I don't do it on purpose.
With someone like Laura, you have to continue to confront her and make it real for her and have her deal with her issues.
5 years I have done this show, I have yelled and screamed bloody murder at every contestant that has walked in these doors. I haven't yelled at you in weeks. Why?
Because you believe I can do it.
No, Laura. Because you don't believe that you can do it. And you make me think that you can't. Why do I have a pervasive feeling with you that no matter what I do or what I say, it's not gonna matter?
Laura's going to get sent home, and if I don't create some awareness for her now, nothing will change for this girl. Nothing. Nothing will be different.
Laura, I'm about to do something so mean, probably the meanest thing I think I've ever done in this entire show. What's the weakest link on this team? Everyone answer the question and tell the truth.
Laura.
Tell the truth.
Laura.
Tell the truth. You're ultimately doing her a favor. You need to trust me right now. Mike.
Laura.
Felipe, weakest link on our team.
Laura.
Okay. Laura.
She's not the weakest link. Laura is not the weakest link. This is a girl that is physically capable, that is strong, that doesn't have injuries, that is athletic, and yet everybody perceives her as the weakest link. Why? Her behavior.
Do you know why they feel this way? Because you have the ability to work out like this. You have the ability to shut up and focus and do the work. But you don't, 99% of the time. You don't. They feel this way because you feel this way. And this is what you are projecting. You have to wake up. Say something. All right. Sonia, please come to the floor. All right, Laura. You're right. I give up.
Laura storms out of the gym. She's in tears. And I'm not gonna chase her. She's not a victim.
You know I'm right.
Come on, I feel bad.
You should, you know what? Because it's sad.
It was by far the meanest thing I've ever seen Jillian do. You just felt horrible. Horrible being there and watching that happen.
She's created this dynamic. Do you deny it?
Deny what? Just the fact that
it takes
her a little bit more to get going.
No,
and stuff like that.
No, Tara. It doesn't take her a little bit more. She's perfectly capable and perfectly strong.
Yeah, but you can't make someone want something.
You know
honey,
what I mean?
You can't.
You think she doesn't want to be healthy? You think she doesn't want to be happy? She's in her own way. By far the meanest thing I've ever done. By far. Because nothing is getting through to her. Nothing. She's desperate. Desperate. And all she has to do is take a real look at herself. That's it. Don't go after her right now. Let her think about this.
Jillian definitely took it too far in this case. Without a shadow of a doubt, she took it to the next level But Jillian's right, Laura can do it. She needs to learn how to push herself and motivate herself to do more.
What she did to me was probably worse than somebody calling me fat to my face or making fun of me.
You ready to talk to me?
Yeah.
Really? Good. What do you want to talk?
After the incident, I wanted to sit down with Laura and explain to her why I did what I did, what it means, and ask her where she thinks she's contributed.
I feel like I've been trying to talk to you about so many different things, and like you haven't given me a chance to talk to you. And then I felt like you threw me under the bus, and you threw Tara under the bus.
You need to hear me right now. The bottom line is that you are phoning it in.
But I don't feel like I'm weak. I feel like you believe that I'm weak.
No, baby. People are picking up that you are not fully committed and present. You are very much in a victim space. Honey, why are you not giving it 100%?
I bet I am.
You...
Laura, you're not.
Tell me why you're here.
I don't know. You ask me all these questions that I can't answer.
Yes, you can. Why do you want to lose weight?
I don't know, maybe because they'll respect me more?
No, that's about them. Why do you want to lose weight?
I want love from everybody, from my friends, my family.
You want love from everybody because you have no love for yourself. There is a bottomless pit of need inside of you, right?
She needs to take care of herself and do this for herself, not for attention and validation from other people.
If it's any consolation at all, I will tell you this. You are capable, and you are strong, and you are a really good person, which is probably why it is so infuriating to me when you give up.
So maybe that's my weakness.
Ultimately, at the end of the conversation, Laura was giving a little bit, maybe copping to some of her behavior. A little baby step is something to hang your hat on right now.
Okay.
I've never felt pressure like this on a weigh-in. Like, the blue team is coming off of loss after loss after loss. We need to win this so bad.
I'm really, really nervous about my weight loss. I mean, this week has been a really rough week. I'm worried that the stress is gonna make my body shut down and I'm not gonna lose a number like I've been losing the past few weeks.
Tonight's weigh-in is unlike anything we have ever done on The Biggest Loser before. You will not be weighing in against each other. You will be weighing in with each other. Tonight's weigh-in is unlike anything we have ever done on The Biggest Loser before. You will not be weighing in against each other. You will be weighing in with each other. At the challenge this week, you all worked hard to give back. So now it's time to give something to you. You all are about to have the chance to win immunity for everyone.
Wow.
If you lost a pound a day for the last week, all of you are guaranteed one more week on campus.
This is
perfect because even if I don't have the highest percentage, I'm still okay if we all do really good.
There are 11 people playing here tonight. That means all of you have to have lost a combined total of more than 77 pounds.
So this weigh-in, everyone can focus on basically the real reason why we're all here, which is to lose weight and to see others succeed.
But if you come in at 77 pounds or below, one person from each team will be going home tonight.
It's scary knowing that you have to lose a pound a day, and everybody has to do it. You know, Helen averages maybe 1 pound a day on a good week.
Something else, in this week of giving back, no matter what happens on the scale tonight, for every pound you have lost, The Biggest Loser will donate 100 pounds of food through Feeding America.
When you look at it, it's kind of a win-win because people are going to get food regardless whether we win this or not. But at the same time, I don't want anybody to go home, and I definitely don't want two people to go home.
We're going to weigh Helen in first. Helen, come on up.
I'm the first one to go up and weigh in. And I'm thinking, oh, geez, please let it be at least 7 pounds because I really need to contribute my part. I need to set that precedent.
Your previous weight was 198 pounds. Your current weight is 193 pounds. You lost 5 pounds this week. Thank you, Helen.
Five is a great number. It really is. But I'm 2 pounds shy. Everybody needs to pull a 7. So I'm looking at my team thinking, who can carry me?
Remember, you need to have lost a combined total of more than 77 pounds to guarantee immunity for everyone. Mandy, we're going to weigh you in next. Mandy, your previous weight was 203 pounds. You have a huge milestone coming up. You hoping to do it tonight?
I hope so. I worked so hard this week. I really did. And so if I do not see at least 199, I am going to be pissed.
All right, well, let's see if it paid off this week. Your current weight is
200 pounds. I started this thing at 263 9 weeks ago, and I'm just like, I never knew I had it in myself to do this. Yay! I can't even, I'm never going back to the 200s ever.
Manny, your current weight is 195 pounds.
Thank you.
Congratulations.
8 pounds. That's awesome. I'm under 200. I made up a little bit for Helen. We still have a long ways to go.
Mandy, you lost 8 pounds this week, bringing the total so far to 13. Okay, guys. Sione, you're up.
I definitely want to pull a 7. But, you know, I want to go above that because if we don't hit over 77 pounds this week, two of us are going home.
Sione. Your previous weight was 286 pounds. Your current weight is
I'm disappointed in myself because now somebody has to pick up the other 4 that I didn't get. you know, and I feel bad because I feel like I let people down.
Thanks, Yanni.
All right.
I think hurting my ankle and, you know, training with Jillian, it did play a factor in my weight loss this week. I felt like I failed.
Sione, you lost 3 pounds this week, adding to the total, making it 16 so far. We have 8 people left to weigh in. Aubrey, you're up.
We should have been at 21 pounds, but we were only at 16. I'm hoping that my weight loss will be my 7 and hopefully even more to contribute to the 5 pounds that we need to make up.
Aubrey, your previous weight was 211 pounds. Your current weight is? 8 pounds in 1 week?
I pulled my 7. I'm totally happy with 8. That's cool.
Congratulations.
Thank you. It's about time I had a decent number. I lost 8 pounds in 7 days. But at the same time, I was only the 4th person to weigh in. We still have 7 people to go, and we have a long ways before 77 pounds.
Aubrey, you lost 8 pounds tonight, making the total so far 24 pounds. Laura. It's your turn.
This week has been really hard. I mean, the number that I put on my scale has to be huge because I have to prove not only to myself, first and foremost, but to everybody here that I'm not weak.
Laura, your previous weight was 233 pounds. Your current weight is? 233 pounds. Your current weight is?
Yes. I wanted to make it a third week of 8, but you know, that's pretty good. 7 pounds a pound a day, and I contributed exactly what I needed to contribute, so.
Good job, Laura.
I'm happy. Thank you.
Thank you.
After this really hard week that I had with Laura, to see her get up and drop 7 pounds on that scale is really rewarding.
Laura, since your first day on campus, you have lost 59 pounds. Woo! You lost 7 pounds this week, adding to the total, making it 31. Remember, if you do not make that 77-pound mark, one member of each team will be going home tonight. Ron, let's see how you did this week.
Going up to the scale, we had a 4-pound deficit, and I'm hoping that I'm able to pick up some of it. I'd have to lose 11 pounds to pick up all of it.
Ron, your previous weight was 349 pounds. Your current weight is?
Number I was hoping for, and wasn't quite a 7, but I guess it is what it is.
Thanks, Ron.
You know, you work as hard as you can, and it makes you feel bad when it just wasn't enough to hit that 7 pounds, and then you're just hoping that there's somebody else out there that'll pick up the slack.
You lost 6 pounds this week, Ron, adding to our total, making it 37 pounds. We have 5 people left to weigh in. Tara, you're up.
Come on, Tara!
When I was walking up to the scale, I saw that there was 37 pounds that we only had thus far. It's scary knowing that you have to go up on that scale and pull a big number right now for the safety of everybody.
Tara, your previous weight was 211 pounds. Your current weight is? are your current weight? It's exactly 200 pounds. You lost 11 pounds in 1 week.
Oh, I'm so excited, Abby.
Well, Tara, to make you a little more excited, you have lost 94 pounds in 9 weeks.
Oh my God, I'm so close. I'm so close.
Congratulations, Tara.
Thank you.
I can't believe that I did it. I started at the ranch at 294 pounds, and now I'm 200 pounds in week 9. And I picked up some of the slack for Sione, for Helen, and for Ron.
Well, Tara, you lost 11 pounds this week, definitely contributing to our total, making it 48 pounds so far. We have 4 people left to weigh in. You need to have lost more than 77 pounds to make sure everyone has immunity this week. Kristen, you're up.
It's my turn to step up on the scale, and we collectively as a group have only lost 48 pounds. And I need to do something really good on this scale to make sure that we hit 77 pounds so nobody goes home.
Your previous weight was 279 pounds. Your current weight is... 9 pounds in 1 week.
I'm just glad that I was able to do my part.
And adding up your total so far, Kristen, you have lost 90 pounds in 9 weeks.
I mean, in 18 years of dieting, I've lost max of 30 pounds. And I've been here for 9 weeks, and I've lost 90 pounds, no magic pills, no surgeries, no nothing, and was able to lose 90 pounds. That's amazing.
Words cannot explain how proud I am, Kristen. And I can't wait till she hits that 100-pound mark.
Kristen, you lost 9 pounds this week, making the total so far 57 pounds. We are 20 pounds away, with 3 people left to weigh in. Felipe, your turn to get on the scale.
Whoa. Walking to the scale, I was nervous because there was only 3 people to weigh in and 20 pounds to lose. And so I was hoping that, you know, at least I pulled my 7 pounds.
Your previous weight was 283 pounds. Your current weight is? 20 pounds away, with 3 people left to weigh in. Your previous weight was 283 pounds. Your current weight is. Lost 8 pounds this week. Your current weight is 275 pounds. Wow. Congratulations.
Thank you.
I lost 8 pounds.
Woo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo. Yeah.
I was doing this dance like this.
Now there's 2 more people left, and hopefully we don't send 2 people home.
Felipe, since you came to campus, you have lost 89 pounds. Actually, you and Sione have lost the exact same amount of weight.
That's a sign of teamwork.
Yeah.
Felipe, you lost 8 pounds this week, adding to your total, making it 65 pounds so far. We have 2 people left to weigh in. Kathy, it's your turn to get on the scale.
The pressure is unbelievable. I don't want to let Black team and Blue team down. I don't want to let America down, and we need to hit this so that we can have the proper donation to feed the hungry.
Kathy, last week you weighed in at 249 pounds. Your current weight is? with one person after you to weigh in, you've only lost 3 pounds, which puts a lot of weight, pardon the expression, on Mike's shoulders. How do you feel?
3 pounds, I wish it was more for the whole effort here. I worked as hard as I could. I gave it my best. I mean, coming off 14 pounds, I wasn't quite sure how my body was gonna react to everything. So.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you. Hitting 3 pounds is like a bittersweet. I mean, great, I've lost 3 pounds, but is that enough? Am I gonna disappoint the blue team and black team that we won't have immunity, you know? And that's a lot of pressure to put on Mike.
Kathy, you lost 3 pounds this week, adding to the total, making it 68. We have one person left to weigh in. Mike, it all comes down to you. In order for everyone to have immunity here, in order to guarantee everyone's safety, one more week on campus, you need to have lost more than 9 pounds.
I can't imagine what Mike is feeling right now. And I can see it in his face, how nervous he is. Like, you are gonna step up on this scale, and if you don't hit more than 9 pounds, two people will be going home tonight.
Get up here on the scale.
Got it, Mike. Let's do
it. Find out how it goes.
Me going last is the worst thing that could happen for me, basically, because I'm already a nervous wreck. I've had 3 double-digit weeks in a row. And, you know, I feel like it's finally catching up and I'm gonna hit a wall. And I just don't feel like I've lost weight this week.
Mike, if you've lost 9 pounds or less, one member of each team will be eliminated tonight.
If I don't lose 10 pounds, I'm killing two people's dreams, basically. And that feeling is horrible. That's way too much pressure for me.
There is a lot of responsibility.
Yeah, just a little.
How do you feel you did this week?
Not good, unfortunately. It's not a good spot to be in right now. I'm a neurotic mess enough, and this doesn't help.
Last week, you weighed in at 297 pounds. Your current weight is